stand together, united in solidarity. Stop blaming the teachers, because no one becomes a teacher to become a millionaire. And we'll keep fighting, because when we fight,
you know, when people talk about teacher compensation, I think often there's a misconception that teachers are greedy, when in reality this is a contract that the district has already agreed to. And it's about using the funds to fund early interventions, to fund psychologists, to fund programs for our students. One of the things that's so hard is I feel like I'm really more of a social worker who teaches a little bit of French when I can. We're dealing with students with incredibly high ACE scores, so adverse childhood experiences, students who are dealing with homelessness, dealing with parents who are incarcerated or having drug and alcohol addiction, I mean, just all kinds of things. And I think that a lot of times people don't realize how much goes into teaching that is not about just delivering lessons and curriculum.
My smallest class is about 30, and the amount of support that I'm able to give them as one person in a classroom of 30 with all of these specialized needs is not there. Society needs to change, and that we need to be part of that change. And this is one of those things where we're trying to be the change.
You know, I think we have a lot of misconceptions about education here in the United States. I've lived in a country where teachers are seen very differently and education is seen very differently. And I just really hope for change.